Hey guys, and welcome back to another Unfiltered Gamer board game review for the game Arkosa. In the game Arkosa, you are playing as one of the many inhabitants in bunkers on the planet. Your colony is going to reside in one of those bunkers, along with, of course, your colony type, and you are attempting to become rescued. After the event happened on the planet, basically a catastrophic event occurred, the planet has basically become a wasteland, and lucky for you, one of the rescuers is coming from an asteroid belt to save you. However, he can only manage to save one colony in one of the bunkers, so hopefully you can build your colony up the best possible in order to be the one chosen to be saved off of the desert wasteland of Arkosa. The game plays 2 to 4 players, takes about 20 minutes per player, and is for ages 13 and up. Will you become the ones who are rescued and saved off of the dying planet, or will you be left to crumble and reside in ruin as your fellow opponents get rescued and saved from the planet? Find out. We'll show you the game down below. I'll give you my review, and then of course we'll have my outro. Hey everyone, and welcome to the game Arkosa, currently set up for 2 players. We'll go ahead and begin the game for setup by placing the board out on the table. After that, place the round marker at 0, stating that it is the setup portion of the game. There are 3 more rounds after this, the 1st, 2nd, and 3rd, which will be covered in the book, and I'll explain them as well. Then, go ahead and take out all the alien colonists, shuffle the deck, and place out 1 in each of these 5 spaces here. There's a little square that denotes where they go. Take the die on the factory and place it in its spot. And then you're going to have this black die, which is numbered, roll it, and then place the event marker on the number you rolled, just like that. Go ahead and give yourself morale, and the way you're going to do that is by looking at the starter board and the starter leader that you're going to have. This is a starter board, and this is the starter leader. And this tells you right here at the bottom middle here how much morale you'll have, and you'll place your little marker on there. In this case, it says 3. And then after that, you're going to go ahead and place all your victory point tokens on the 0 space on the board. Over here is going to be your beginning resources that you can trade. It's 1 food and 1 nitrogen. And finally, take all the A tiles for the rooms and place them into the bag and pull 4 and place them in these 4 spots. They're going to function very similarly to the colonists. Then take the events, the easy, medium, and hard events that are going to come out in the game, shuffle them up and place them near everybody. Go ahead and take the colonists, make sure they're both shuffled. These are the Dr. Sawbones cards, which will repair and heal your workers. And these are nasty, catastrophic events that will pop up throughout the game. Shuffle these as well. And finally, bribery cards. Just go ahead and shuffle them and set them aside. You won't be using them until round 2 and 3. Any additional boards and stuff like that can be set to the side as well. Then give every single player, like I said, 1 starting leader and a player board that has the symbol A on it if you're starting the game and you never played before. After that, every single player board is going to come equipped with these 3 starting tokens with the anvil side up. And of course, they're going to have a turn-based token, and you can go ahead and place that there. Then give everybody their starting the resources. And to find out what your starting resources are, you're going to take your board, you're going to look at the bottom middle, and that is what you're going to get to begin the game. After you've done that, give somebody the first player marker, and they can start the game off. To begin the game, it's pretty simple. You'll take 2 actions, and then you'll pass your turn. If you don't want to take any actions, and you choose to pass because you want to, well, then you're done for the round, and everybody else will have a chance to pass. And when that happens, the round will end, and the next round will begin. Before that happens, you're going to go ahead and move this to the first round, and now this player can begin the game. You have a bunch of different actions you can choose from, and lucky for you, you're going to be able to look at your player board here, and it will explain what you can do. The first thing is, you can put a colonist to work, and in order to do that, every single player is going to draw 4 colonist cards to begin the game. These colonists are going to have a victory point symbol in the bottom left, and they're going to have actions that you can choose to do with them. Anything that isn't a backpack is a resource that you can gain, and that is how you put them to work. You'll take them and place them on the left side of your board, gain the valuable resources, whether it be nitrogen, whether it be food, or cogs, or scraps, and then you'll place it to the side. That's how you put them to work. Pretty simple. Then that's an action. The next action is you can explore. to explore, you'll check the backpack on your colonist. Then you'll associate it with one of the backpack spaces on the board, usually in the bottom left-hand side of each of the spaces, and you'll perform that action. Then you'll place your character on the left-hand side of your board, meaning that he has been utilized. These are the exploration locations here. When you explore a space with a colonist, you'll gain that colonist. If you have more than six, you'll have to get rid of a colonist and take a penalty. And if not, you'll put it into your hand. The backpack symbols represent the types of colonists you'll need in order to use the space. Then this represents this moving one, two, or three spaces based on the space that you choose. So in this case, it would be one space. Whenever it lands on a certain symbol, you're going to gain a resource benefit or an event card. You'll draw the card and read it out and do whatever it says. Or if it is a resource, you'll just simply gain it. Pay the resource required, take the card, and then move everything down the line. If, of course, it is a resource, like this one here, you'll just simply take the resources after you move the event tracker, have the guy with the backpack, and spend the resources required. If for some reason, after you take the event, and you can't afford to take the character, you can actually choose to do a lower ability on the track. So if you choose the three here, and you end up having to pay two food and a nitrogen, and then you can't afford it because you lost your other food, you can choose to do this one instead, or this one instead. You just can't go up on the track. And that is how all the exploration acts worked. You're either going to get a colonist, you're going to get some scraps, or some type of resource. The next action that you can choose to do is you can build a room. And building a room works similar to the gathering the colonists. You're going to pay the cost on the bottom right-hand side of the room. You'll take the room and place it on your player board. When you place it on your player board, it must always go right below one of the other previously built rooms. And rooms are not active unless they have these tokens on them. So as long as they have these tokens on them, during the production phase of the round, you'll be able to utilize them. And if you ever have one of these, you can just simply put it on your board whenever you want. Once it's placed, it stays there though, but that means that the room is active. So that is how you gain rooms. When you gather a room, you'll take a new room from the bag and you will place it down onto the board, just like this. And rooms will function just like aliens. If this one goes, then these all will move down the line and a new one will come from the bag and be placed down there. Final things is you can make a trade, which allows you to do any of these things here, spending resources for these type of items here, or of course you can spend resources for Dr. Sawbones, which will repair and heal your characters, or you can trade in this little market over here as well, as long as there is something here to trade for. And finally, it's make a bribe. You can't do this until round two or three, but in round two, a certain number of these will come out face up. You can take one of these cards and add it to your collection. They have a cost to them. If you can pay for them at the end of the game, you'll get the victory points associated with them. So on your turn, take one of those actions, take another one of those actions, and then the next player will go. Once everybody passes, the round will end and it will move to the next round. Before it moves to the next round, however, you are going to have to do a certain number of things. The first thing is you're going to have to pay rations. For each of your colonists, you're going to have to provide a certain number of food and nitrogen. And if you cannot afford them, you'll go down on your morality track. You're then going to gain morality points based on where your token is and associated with that number. So for instance, orange would get -1 point and white would get 0. But if they were all the way up here, then orange would get 4 and white would get 5. If you ever get more than the highest amount of morality, you're going to gain a victory point. And if you ever take somebody's space, they'll simply move down. So you're always going to be just swapping places with the person that you most recently walked up to. Or for instance, if orange had to move down a space, then white would go up one and orange would go down one. You're never going to share the same space on the morality tracker. After that, you are then going to move on to the room production. You're going to produce based on the rooms that you have available that are active. And the bottom left of the room is going to tell you what types of things you're going to get. So in this case, this player would get 2 nitrogen, 2 food, 2 reputation, a healing of one of their colonists, and another blue. And if this room were green, they would get an additional food. So there are certain production bonuses as well as doublings. This one here gives you victory points, and that one gives you a scrap when you place it on there. After you've generated all your resources in turn order, then you are going to move on to the resting of colonists. You're going to take any colonists that you have played, most likely all of them, on this side of the board, and you're going to put them back into your hand. Once you do that, any of your unhealed colonists will stay on the right-hand side of your board. You're going to move this marker over, and the next player will get a chance to go. Now, in each subsequent round, there's certain things that will happen. In round two, you'll take all of these colonists here, And then you're going to gather the bee colonists and put them out onto the board. You're also going to get rid of this item here and move these guys down. And then all of the bee locations will go into the bag, and you'll draw one and put it out onto the board. Could be an A or a B, depending on what's in the bag here. And then you are going to continue the game. The last little thing you do on round two is you would actually go ahead and take out the bribery cards, these guys here, a certain number based on the number of players. And on your turn, as an action, you can take one of these guys here. And as long as you can pay for it at the end of the game, you'll get those points. Otherwise, you will lose them. The final round of the game triggers in the same way. You'll take one of these guys away and one of these guys away. You move the things down the board, add new things, and then after everybody has taken all their actions and passed, the game will end, and whoever has the most points along this track here is the winner. You'll be scoring bonus points for each of the colonists that you have. Each of the rooms that you have will provide a bonus as well, and any extra resources that you have left over will score you points too. Highest point value means you get to explore the outer reaches of Arkosa, and you won't be left to fend for yourself on a dying planet. Arkosa is part engine building, part Euro, resource management, and hand management. Your objective in the game is to gather colonists. These colonists will be worth points at the end of the game, and you're going to try and get the most points at the end of the game. You're also going to be developing rooms in your bunker. These rooms will produce certain things throughout the rounds, and you're basically trying to gather all the resources you can to build the best rooms, create the best bunker, maintain happiness in your colony, and have the best colonists. All of these will translate to victory points at the end of the game. Whoever has the most is the winner. It's quite simple, but there is a lot of variation and a lot of different things that can happen in the game. There's event cards, and there's three different types, and they function the same, but have different events and different probabilities of the types of events that are going to come from them. Are you going to get a red event, which is likely going to be something nasty, or are you going to get a green event, which is likely to be something good? You're going to find that out as you explore certain locations to gather new colonists, to gain more resources, to build more bunkers. There is, of course, player interaction, but most of that comes in the choices that you make on the game as to what you type of bunker options you choose, what type of colonists you choose, and certain colonists are able to do certain things to opponents, like steal their resources. But in general, your objective is to make sure that you have the best colony possible for the rescue. And at the end of the game, having the most reputation means you're going to be rescued. There is a lot of choices in the game, but if you break it down quite simply, you can actually look at your little card here and it explains how it works. You're going to be able to explore, build a room, make a trade, make a bribe, and basically your objective is to save those resources as best as humanly possible to maintain the best choices you can. And then, of course, at the end of the game, you dump everything and hopefully succeed with that reputation. The quality of the game is excellent. This would not surprise me if this was the final version of the game. However, I do think that there's probably going to be a few changes here and there. The different aspects I really do enjoy are, of course, the artwork. It's really unique. It kind of feels like kind of like a 70s, 80s retro vibe, kind of like meets a Dune style comic book. And then, of course, it has the, like, I don't know exactly how to explain it, like a Fallout type gameplay, because you actually are going to have your own unique bunker. I'm going to take one of these guys here. And there's going to be multiple choices you can make at the beginning of the game. Do you want to create your own bunker, use the starting variety of bunkers? You can kind of create your own, have your own race, or you can use one of the starting races. Everybody gets a certain number of resources that's a little different in the game, but functions thematically fairly and evenly balanced. The bunkers, as the rounds go on, become more beneficial, but have a higher cost, and you're hopefully going to be producing more resources than what you started with in each of the subsequent rounds. Colonists are also the same way, in which they are going to have a higher cost, but a better benefit, higher victory points. Getting rid of certain colonists will provide you with additional points, but may also cost you for having to get rid of the previous colonists that you had. So choosing to wait might be better than choosing to gather as many as you possibly can and then keep gathering them. So you're kind of trying to balance the happiness of your population via the amount you have, and of course maintaining enough food and resources to feed them and keep them happy, because does morality, it translates to victory points for each and every round. What's also cool too is the exploration aspect of the game. When you explore a certain area, you'll take this token and move around the board, and you're going to run into certain things, whether it be additional scrap pieces or resources like food or nitrogen, or you might encounter an event. Eventually, you're going to encounter these catastrophic events. These are really nasty things that affect any players that it specifically states. Maybe it's the player with the most food or the most nitrogen, a player who has the best variety of a certain type of room and colonists, and it can basically kind of give a catch-up mechanic to those who are a little bit farther behind based on certain criteria. The game setup for each round is very simple. You're basically going to clear the board from all certain things, and it explains it in the rules how it works, adding new colonists, adding more rooms to the bag, pushing onto the next round, all the player markers switch, and it feels very, very fluid as to how that works. So overall, it's a really fun game. I really enjoyed this one here. I played with Max and Callie, played with Josh, and then I played with my buddy Mikey and Kelsey. This game was a lot of fun each and every time because there's so many different strategies that you can choose from, and it's always going to be a close point total at the end of the game. You're not going to feel like somebody is really, really far ahead. There's good choices that you can make that can benefit you and net you a bunch of resources, but that resource translation is pushed into points at the end of the game. So if you don't manage to spend everything, you can utilize those for points, which can net you a positive outcome at the end of the game. The thematic aspect is really cool too, because you do feel like you are building a bunker. You feel like you are controlling the people that you have, and you're utilizing them for certain actions. Maybe you want them to go exploring. Maybe you want to utilize their abilities. Or maybe you just want to roll a die with them and see what happens. You can have those choices in the game. Reflecting on what other players choose to do might reflect on what items you get or bunkers you get or types of resources you go for, but the choices are all available. It's not like a certain spot gets taken up and you can't have that. But what instead happens in the competitive aspect is if somebody takes this guy here, all the guys move down and a new guy pops up, which might even be better for you in the long run. I was complaining a little bit because my wife wanted a space that I wanted after I had spent all this time to gather the resources. She said, okay, I won't take it from you. And then I felt bad, of course, because she didn't take it from me. And then when it came down to my turn, a new bunker room came out that was a lot better and I wanted that one. But I had previously whined about not having the other one, so I took the other one. So lessons learned that it's okay that players take certain things because new things will come out that you might want that might be even better for your strategy. But anyway, the game itself is solid. If you like a game with hand management, resource management, the ability to customize your own builds and kind of have this unique form-fitting game, or if you want to go ahead and just choose to use what they start with, it's still going to give you variation, which is nice as well. If you're interested in this type of game, I highly suggest you take a look at the link down below in the description. It's currently on Kickstarter. I really had a good time with this one, and I think you might as well. So go ahead and take a look. Thank you for watching another Unfiltered Gamer board game review for the game Arkosa. If you're interested, go ahead and check the link like I said before, and of course, subscribe to the channel. Hit that subscribe button and the bell notification button to see more videos that we put out every day for games just like this one on Kickstarter, so you can determine if it's good for you. Let us know in the comments, is this a game you've played before? Is it not? Is it something you want to pick up? Have you seen the Kickstarter? What are your thoughts? I'm curious as to what you guys think, because for me, I think this game is a lot of fun. And for those of you guys who like hand management euros with resource management, it's something I would definitely suggest checking out, as long as you don't mind that there is a bit of luck in it involving die roll, and of course the amount of the different tiles that pop out. You know, some are better than others, and you have to kind of make those choices. You can also go ahead and check out our live streams every Sunday, 6:30 p.m. PST, where we stream games just like this one. You can also go ahead and check out our unfilteredgamer.com, new reviews out every week, and of course thank you Patreon members for supporting us every month. A buck has helped us out greatly, and we do appreciate it, and we'll be hopefully giving away another game this Sunday. I keep saying Wednesday because this is a new stream day. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. As always, I look forward to escaping the planet of Arkosa without you next time.